Let's talk about politics, for example. You in 2015 actually gave up your national award for Khosla Ka Ghosla because of what was happening in FTII. You made a political statement in a sense by doing what you did. Would you do it today? For example, if there was a lynching, I've seen other literateurs and award winners giving back their award, the so-called award Wapsi campaign, when a man was lynched allegedly for storing beef in his house. Would you, on a starkly political issue like that, take a stand? Or is it more comfortable for you to be in an area where you're taking stands on an issue like FTII?
I'll take a stand, but comfort doesn't have much to do with it. I think my stands are reserved. You see, stands work a bit like, now you're a conscientious person, and let's say you're saving up to give your money for a charitable cause. And ultimately, you'll have to choose between two charitable causes. Mm-hmm. And you will go with the cause that you have made up your mind about, that this is something that I will give whatever I can to, and that'll always be at the cost of something else. That does not make you a lesser person or you a less committed person. It's a stand. I have taken stands through my films, and the award Wapsi episode that happened in 2015 happened because I was seeing one of many educational institutions being eviscerated, and an institution is systems, an institution is the hotlines of teaching, an institution is questioning, an institution is debate. The first thing that you do in a classroom is ask a question. Without asking a question, no classroom can go ahead with a period. And what I realized was that asking questions about how FTII's governing body and its chairman were appointed were being deemed as illegal activities, and students were being put in jail about asking those questions. Hence, I decided, along with some other people, to give my award back so that I could draw the attention of parents and students and teachers and citizens across India to this problem. It was an attention-seeking device to draw the attention of parents and teachers who are not only film students, but who are students of other educational institutes. That's why I did what I did then. The lynchings, the dread, this feeling of something's wrong at the back of our heads, I knew it would happen. I predicted it. During our many interviews, during the award Wapsi, I said that if we don't speak now, this is where we will be today. So I will again, since you're asking that, what will you save your next award for? I've got only two. So abhi ek hi bacha hai. So I will save it for probably another such seminal incident, which probably is a focus and which probably can stand for many other such things to come in future if we don't check that thing there. Today, the lynchings, the killings, the sense of, as you said, self-censorship, it's all there because when there was time and when we could say, we didn't even squeak, and now we can't even squeak. And therefore, I'm the one who's saying, I told you so. So I will choose my next award to be given up for somewhere when we come to that incident, which will again, to me, will become a symbol of, if you don't stop now, it's going to get far worse.
I'm getting the sense, though, in the last couple of years, you've become a little silent. Has the anger gone out of you? Has the rage gone out of you? 2015, you were angry, your cinema was reflecting that. Films like Shanghai, films like Love, Sex or Dhoka, you were trying to stretch the boundaries. Now you're doing Netflix films on love. You know, you've moved into areas. Are you more comfortable talking about now? Have you softened up? Is there a self-censorship?
I love that contempt in your voice when you say Netflix films about love, and we will discuss this.
It was like a love story.
No, sure. No, I'm just saying that it's interesting. because it's related. No, I mean, there's a saying in Bengali, and I mean it. Dudh kola diye pushchi. What it means is that I'm feeding my anger milk and bananas. And I'm getting it sort of, you know, even sort of, you know, readier and readier. Now, what's happened in my real life is that I finished Byomkesh, and then I got busy with love stories. And after that, I had a film, which was always on the cards, and I made it. For me, it takes time, two and a half years to finish every film and go to the next one. But the anger has not gone away, nowhere. But it's changed. It's modified into something, but that's my personal answer to it. I realized that whatever's happening is not an isolated political incident. To me, I think whatever's happening is related to many, many other things, one of which is the scared and angry male, which is why I made what I made for Love Stories. It is about two scared males and one woman trying to break out of the fear.